Every summer, there's a dedicated team of volunteers working in the Adirondacks to count and document the number of loons as part of efforts to help conserve the birds and their habitat on many lakes and ponds in the wilds of the Adirondacks. Our producer Michael Hansen has the story.
The Loon Census is a community science effort that's been running since 2001, and essentially hundreds of volunteer observers across the park and beyond, just anywhere in New York State, go out on the third Saturday of July every year from 8 to 9 a.m. And they go out on either a lake or a designated area of a bigger lake. People go out on a smaller lake if they can cover the whole thing in an hour, or they'll split up a bigger one. And they'll go out and they'll count the number of loons they observe. They'll age them to either adults or chicks or immatures. And then they'll look for other observations like eagles, or maybe if the loons are nesting, or just behavioral observations that they want to report. And then they submit that data to us and we compile it, and then we're able to show apparent population trends of the loons across the park and beyond in New York State on an annual basis. The general trends that we're seeing from 2001 to 2024 is that we're seeing fewer lakes with no loons observed, and we're seeing more lakes with adults only. So it seems like we're seeing more loons over time, but we're actually seeing fewer lakes over time with offspring with those adults. So what it seems like is there's a lot of loons in the park, but over time it seems like reproductive success might be going down a little bit. There are some things that might be happening, like over this 20 plus year period, obviously climate change has intensified. We know that from studies like those have been done by Kurt Steger at Paul Smith College, where we're having more torrential rain events every summer. And because loons nest right at the water's edge, their nests are really susceptible to nest flooding. And so maybe climate change is something that's causing these loons to have lower reproductive success. There's a potential confounding factor there where people might be going out and choosing lakes where they know that loons are on them, because it's the New York annual Loon Census. They want to go out and they want to count loons on the Loon Census, which is great. We want people out there observing loons. But there might be people who know, oh, there's this lake over here that has no loons, and I know this one over here does. I'm gonna go count the one with loons on it. So we have some people who have been observing for years for us and haven't seen loons in years, which it's actually really helpful for our data, because the best thing we can do is have the same lakes sampled year after year after year, and then we can look at trends in the same areas and try to extrapolate that out to the rest of the population. Loons are important to study. We call them a sentinel species, which basically means they're a good warning sign and a good indicator for the environment, the health of our aquatic ecosystems here in the park and beyond. Loons are a freshwater species. In the summertime, they eat a lot of freshwater fish. We think they eat thousands of pounds of fish every year. So if they're in a fresh body of water, it can tell you a lot about that body of water. Like, it has a healthy food web. There has to be a large amount of food resources to be able to support a loon. There can't be a lot of contamination if they are going to have good reproductive success, because we know that contamination from pollutants like mercury lowers the reproductive success. And we also know that water clarity is really important for loons as well. They need to be able to see under the water when they're foraging for these fish. Loons are what we call a classic K-selected species, which means that they are really long-lived and they have a low reproductive rate. There's actually a banded pair of loons, which unfortunately in recent years they've split up. It seems like they're no longer a mated pair, but they live on Seney Wildlife Refuge in Michigan. They were banded in the late 80s, and as of this year, we now know, because of these banded loons, that loons could live into their 40s. So loons are very long-lived, we know that, but they also have a very low reproductive rate. We think on average, the average loon pair produces about one fledgling chick every 2 years, so that's about half a chick every year. So the key to maintaining a viable loon population is to keep these healthy breeding adults alive for a long period of time, for that long lifespan, to ensure that with their low reproductive rate, they can reproduce successfully over time. What we really want to talk to people about is this really charismatic species that everybody loves, and kind of the symbolism of the wilderness in the Adirondacks for them are these loons. They live out on these freshwater lakes, sometimes in really remote areas. People remember camping next to the water, hearing the loons call for the first time. We hope that we can inspire conservation through this love of loons. Loons, again, they're a great indicator species. So if we can teach people about the ecosystems that they inhabit and get people to care about loons, a lot of the efforts that we try to inspire will help the ecosystem as a whole as well. There's always a really, really huge thank you that's due to all of our census observers, whether that's somebody that's been observing every single year, always puts it on their calendar and won't miss it since 2001, all the way up to somebody who said, you know what, I want to try this and did it for the first time this year. We get hundreds of submissions every year from hundreds of lakes across the park and beyond. And as a small nonprofit, there's no possible way that we could do this without the effort of all these people. There's always just a really huge thank you that's due to everybody who's helping out with the census, because I mean, we could not do this work without them.